Hello traders, can you hear me all right? Can you see my screen? Thanks a ton for your responses. On behalf of NP Financials and Go Markets, I welcome you all to this market structure and dynamics revealing session. I thank you all for taking time out from your otherwise busy timeline and for attending to this session. I'm here to share my experience so that you can understand and take the steps to get started to know what is the structure of the market you are trading and what are the underlying mechanics and dynamics of the market you are trading. May it be Forex, may it be any other asset class. At the end of this webinar, you'll get the opportunity to ask questions and let you know. This session will be around 40 to 45 minutes. First thing first, let's get started with the risk warning. NP Financials Pty Ltd advises all service recipients of the following. This information is provided only on a general advice basis and does not take into account your objectives, financial situations or needs. This webinar is only educational in nature. Let me give you some more time to go through the rest of it. Now that you have gone through it, let's get started. Today, I will cover the following. What constitutes a market? What do you understand? What to expect from a market? What is a market? Who are the market? Etc. Please raise your hand if you do not understand what I said. I'll be more than happy to explain it further. Please let me know if I speak too fast or too slow, or if we miss something which you want me to repeat. Please do not choose to suffer in silence. So the next one after market constituents, what I'll be doing, I'll interpret the price representation and tell you bar by bar how to read the price which is getting printed in your chart or charting software, may it be 1 minute chart or a monthly or weekly or daily chart, doesn't matter. You need to understand how the human emotions of greed and fear getting represented and captured in the price bars. Then we'll talk about the trend analysis. I will tell you the first term, second term and third term, or the short term, medium term and long term trend, how you can professionally identify these three trends and take advantage of these three trends and be aligned in this, so that from one chart, so that you can really understand whether the market is trending or ranging, and if it is trending, how to take advantage of it and how far. Next, I'll talk about the bar by bar price analysis, how to understand each and every bar and how to interpret bar by bar the market you are trading. I'll introduce you to the very important concept of peaks and troughs. They are different from the generic swing highs and swing lows. I'll tell you what is the difference exactly mathematically defined so that you will never forget again. Many people talk about drawing a trend lines, and most of it, 90 or very high percent of it, are actually arbitrary trend lines, because we need to know the difference between valid and invalid trend lines. We need to know how to draw a tentative and a confirmed trend line. I will tell you what is the invalid trend line, what is the valid tentative trend line, and when the valid tentative trend line is getting confirmed to a valid confirmed trend line. And that is the trend line we are interested in technical trading. I'll also introduce you to the concept of supply and demand in trading so that you can easily understand. And first of all, you need to identify and capture or draw in your chart the supply points for that market and the demand points for that market. Once you understand and have drawn and captured the supply and demand points, it will be easy to trade on around those sweet spots of supply and demand. I'll also tell you what is the difference between support resistances in comparison to supply and demand, and how to identify the hidden supports and hidden resistances, so that if you are knowledgeable about the hidden supports and resistances, so that we are not falling in trap of the market participants, big or small. I'll talk about the wave structure of price. This is nothing to do with Elliott wave. I'll tell you how you can solve in this price action, which is in front of, which is getting printed in front of you in the chart. I'll tell you the structure and the dynamics. And last but not the least, I'll talk about the competition details, how you can participate and win prizes. All right, let me get started with audience participation. I'll ask very simple questions to you so that you can get started knowing each other better. Who is trading professionally now? So you can respond in your chat section. Professional trading means your income is coming from trading. Who is trading? Next question. Part-time and working full-time. Yep, most of you probably working part-time or working full-time. 9 to 5 is a full-time job, and after that you're coming and looking for the charts, and that is part-time trading. You need to be very careful about that. Who is the third question? Who is not ready to trade yet? That's not a problem. I love greenfield projects, and you can get started anytime. If you have the willingness and the focus and determination, you can persist and be consistent. Last but one question, most important one, who wants to learn to trade like the professional? Yeah, most of you, yeah, thank you, great. Most of you wants to learn like a professional, that's why you were attending this webinar of Go Markets and NP Financials. Last questions, what is stopping from trading consistently? You can capture this, you don't have to answer now probably. Think about it, write it down, and then send it back across to support@gomarkets.com.au and we'll respond to that. Alright, we'll start with our first topic point, what constitutes a market? Let's go one by one. Market consists of price plots. And what is price plots? Price plots, as you have seen in the chart, price keeps on plotting the highs and lows in the open and close, and thereby forming patterns and so on and so forth. But what actually are these price plots and how they get plotted? Human behavior, according to me, I'm a great believer of this, plots the price effect. The human behavior plots the price effect. How? Greed and fear builds human behavior. As we are built on greed, on blood and bone and muscles, we are also built on greed and fear. That is very common to us. The greed and fear behavior is consistent. Because we are human being, we are greed, and we are actually governed by our greed and fear. So understanding greed greed and fear is extremely important in trading. This underlying behavior, consistent of behavior of greed and fear, which is extremely consistent, causes the price pattern in the marketplace to be consistent and repetitive, and that is our advantage. We take advantage of this consistently repetitiveness of the markets, and we trade accordingly, and that can be consistent again. So getting consistency in trading is actually understanding our own greed and fear. That's why you will see probably at the bottom, when people are greedy, they will buy the instrument, and at the top, when people are fearful at the top formation, they will sell the instrument. Alright, moving on. How to read the price representation? What are the elements? Let's get started. Price representation can be done either through OHLC price bar, open, high, low, close. I'll explain you in details. Or you can choose to print through candlesticks. The difference between candlesticks and open, high, low, close, when I'll take a webinar on candlesticks, you'll more understand that. But for the time being, if you cover the open and close with a body like structure, the price bars will be converted into candlesticks. I'll talk about that later on in another webinar. Then the closing price, only the line. So either you can print the line chart instead of a OHLC or a candlesticks, and that will be your closing price. We the professionals prefer the closing price. And other variations also, you can do point and figure, Renko, three line break, etc., etc. All these representations actually being done only through the capture of what is the emotion, underlying emotions of the participants. And there are three kinds of participants in this market, including you and me. Investors who invest for long term. Second is mutual fund manager or hedge fund managers. And the third type of are the traders or the speculators like us, who speculate on the behavior of investors and traders and participate in their direction. If we are not in sync with the market, then we'll have tough problem understanding the underlying dynamics and structure of the market. Alright, moving on. Now I will start trend analysis and I'll show you charts. But first thing first, there are three types of trends which can be defined by the highs and lows of the price bar. So you don't have to go to multiple time frame to know the trend, underlying trend. That is not at all required. I will tell you the trick, the magic of identification of short term, medium term, long term, or first term, second term, and third term trend in a single chart. If you are trading 1 minute chart, that is fine. 5 minutes, 3 minutes, 15 minutes, 30 minutes, doesn't matter. 1 hourly, 4 hourly, 12 hourly, day, weekly, or monthly, doesn't matter. I'll tell you a trick, and the magic you will come to know when you practice a lot. Let's get started. The first term or the short term uptrend is built on higher highs and higher lows between successive bars. I will tell you in the next slide the actual diagram, how it will look like. But if you are a trader already trading, or if you are a novice trader just started, you'll probably know that if I am taking two bars and the second bar high is higher than the first one, and the second bar's low is higher than the first bar, then I will consider that as the first term or short term uptrend. So if it is a weekly chart or a daily chart, the two bars on the right hand side is actually telling me what is the first term or the short term uptrend. Next, first term downtrend is just the opposite, is built on the lower highs and lower lows between the successive bars. We are taking the last two bars, no one knows the right hand side, but everyone sees the left hand side, and everyone knows the left hand side. So if we are taking the last two bars, if the last bar low is lower than the previous bar low and the last bar high is lower than the previous bar high, that is known as first term downtrend. It can be 5 minutes or 15 minutes chart. Time is independent. This trend analysis is independent of the time. The second term trend is defined by peaks and troughs. First of all, I will let you know what is a peak, what is a trough, and then I will tell you the second term trend, how to identify it through the peaks and the troughs. If the peaks are going up and the troughs are going up, then we will call the second term trend or the medium term trend is up. If the peaks and troughs are both coming down successively, then I'll consider the second term trend or the medium term trend of that instrument in that time frame is short or down. Last one is the third term trend, which is defined by P star and T star. P star and T star are nothing but the peaks and troughs, but they are very mathematically defined and they are a little bit different from normal second term peaks and troughs, which I will explain. Moving on, the bar by bar price analysis. I'll come to that trend analysis of course, but let me first show you what kind of bars we are talking of and what kind of bar we will neglect in a trend analysis. This is also what important to know what not to do in trading. We can have inside bar, so the second bar high is lower than the last, I'll again consider the two bars. The last bar high, to be called as an inside bar, is lower than the previous bar high, and the last bar low is higher than the previous bar low. So we have a higher low and a lower high to form an inside bar, which actually represents an indecision depending on where it is in the context of the trend it is appearing. Is it appearing at the middle of the trend or at the fag end of the trend or at the start of the trend? Then we have a concept of outside bar. Let me define again. The last bar high is higher than the previous bar and last bar low is lower than the previous bar, then it is an outside bar. Again, the behavior would be of the outside bar is actually again can be trend changing if it is appearing at a support or a resistance or a supply or demand point, or actually it can be an indecision bar as well if it is appearing at the middle of the trend. That's why it is so important. Outside bars, if we convert it in a support to a candlesticks, will be probably known as a bullish engulfing. If it is appearing at a supply point, we'll call it an bearish engulfing. The important point here is how to understand the combination of inside, outside, inside, inside, outside, inside, and outside, outside. So if we have two bars, there can be four possibilities. If we have three, then it can be I, O, 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 I, O, I, etc. It can be tongue twister. So inside, inside, so all these combinations actually, double inside bar like I, double outside bar like O, O, can be very powerful and very meaningful to understand whether and when and which direction the price is getting to break out after this formation of inside inside outside outside bars. Very simple concept, but very powerful, and because these are the little things which will be extremely big while you are trading. Now we have a kind of signal bar. That signal bar will define on what type of strategies you are trading. For example, range trading or train trading or swing trading or momentum trading or divergence trading or any kind of trading you are doing, bounce or breakouts, blah blah blah. So you have to define, and I'll tell you, I'll help you to define that signal bar, the bar which signals an up or a long trade to be taken or a short trade to be taken. And that bar which is triggered, there can be an entry bar. So if the signal bar is triggered, then we enter, and that can be an entry bar. And the reversal bar, like an opposite turning point or a bar which is appearing at a resistance with a bearish divergence, I'll define them. And a reversal bar can be a take profit bar. So the signal bar followed by an entry bar, we are entering, and a reversal bar, we are exiting or closing the trade. And in between, if we have a combination of inside outside, we'll handle it bar by bar. That's why it is important to understand. Indecision bars are like inside outside bars. In candlesticks, they are actually known as dozy. Dozy means indecision bars. Again, in the context of where they are appearing, whether they are appearing at the middle of the trend or the fag end or the starting point of the trend. Concepts of up bar. So we know OHLC. Now let's define what is an up bar, so that you will understand the concept of peaks and troughs. So when the current bar, which is the last bar, prints a higher high and higher low compared to its previous bar, then it is known as up bar. So as you can see, the last bar here is high, this high is higher than that high, previous high, and this low is higher than this low, and this high is higher than this. So this, all these three, sorry, all these two, not this one, because you don't know the left hand side, I have not captured it. So this one, higher high, higher low, this one, higher high, higher low, are actually up bar. Don't get confused that up bar has to be a bullish bar in which the close is greater than the open. That is not a must, because when the close is greater than the open, then we have a bullish bar. When the close is lower than the open, we have a bearish bar. But this is, we are not considering the close and open. That's why we are considering the high and low, high and low, to consider this as an up bar. Now let's go to the opposite of the concepts of down bar. When the current bar prints a lower high and the lower low compared to the previous bar, then it is a down bar. So this low, last one, this bar low is lower than this one, and this bar high is lower than this one. So all these in front of you are down bars. Don't get confused again that all down bars needs to be a bearish bar. The chart happens to show that way, but it is not a must. A bullish bar can also be a down bar, and a bearish bar can also be an up bar, because you are considering the high and low, not the open and close. Now I'll make you understand the concepts of peak. Once we know the down bar and up bar, we'll combine them. So when the down bar is preceded by an up bar, that establishes as a peak. So why this, the last bar, why this is a down bar? Because this last bar low is lower than the previous bar, and this last bar high is lower than the previous bar. So this is a down bar. And why this is an up bar, the middle one, forget about the left one, the middle one, because the middle one high is higher than the previous one, and middle bar low is higher than this one. So that's why this has satisfied the up bar, and this has satisfied the definition of a down bar. So a down bar is preceded by an up bar. The high of the up bar is a peak. So that is very mathematically defined. So this high is higher than that, this high is higher than this, but this low is lower than this, and this low, second bar, middle bar low is higher than the first bar low. So I hope you have understood the concept of peaks. In understanding the difference between swing high and peak, the third bar cannot be an inside bar for a definition of a peak, but it can be considered for a swing high. Now let's go to the concepts of troughs, just the opposite. When an up bar is preceded by a down bar, that establishes a trough. So this up bar, why this is up? See, this is a bearish bar, but an up bar, because this third last bar high is higher than the previous one, and last bar low is higher than the previous one. So this is up bar. So what I'm telling you, when the up bar is preceded by a down bar, why this is a down bar? Because this low is lower than that, and this high is lower than that. So the low of the down bar in a three bar combination is the trough. And the third bar, the last bar, cannot be an inside bar to define it as a trough. I hope you have understood the concept of the up bar, down bar, peaks and troughs. So once we have understood that, let me clear the definition of a valid downtrend line. So how to draw a valid downtrend line? Please do not join arbitrary points to draw a trend line. When there is a trend, there must be a trend line. So downtrend line is drawn by joining two consecutive swing highs, and it gets validated when price crosses the in-between swing low. So how does it look like? So once we have got a swing high, because this high is higher than the previous one and this high is higher than the next one, it can be a peak as well, but swing high is good enough. So we got a swing high and a swing high here, and in between swing low, because this low is lower than the previous one and the next one. So we'll join this swing high, lower swing high, to the previous higher swing high, provided there is a swing low in between. So if there is no swing low, this is an invalid trend line. And this trend line will be tentative till the point this low of the swing low is taken out. That means this bar, any bar, is actually crossing the swing low low. So we have a swing high which is lower than the previous swing high and the swing low. Till this point, the swing low is taken out to the right hand side. This is tentative trend line, and I will explain, and I'll probably draw it as a dot 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 or dash dash. And when this low of the swing low is taken out, then I'll confirm this line by drawing a firm trend line. So this is a valid downtrend line. Now let's draw a valid uptrend line, just the opposite. Uptrend line is joining by two consecutive swing low, provided there is a swing high in between. Otherwise, please do not draw, it will be an invalid line, and market will not actually respect your drawn lines. If you have drawn it correctly, market will respect. If you have drawn it incorrectly, then market is not going to respect that line. So we have a swing low which is higher than the previous swing low. It can be trough as well, but we have in between swing high, between these two swing lows. So we'll join this swing low to swing low and wait. That will be a tentative trend line, and wait for this swing high to be taken out to change this to a confirmed trend line. That's why people think that why my trend line is not respected by the market participants, because we have not followed the definition of a valid trend line. Now I'll explain you what is the effect of supply and demand in trading. Supply and demand are the sweet spots of trend reversals and or continuation. Supply and demand can be considered as leading indicator because they are identified and drawn much before they are retested and respected by the market participants. The zones of supply and demand can be identified by plotting. I'm now telling you how to plot the pivot lines, the monthly, weekly or daily. Pivot line are simple lines. You have to take the previous month high, plus previous month's low plus close divided by 3. Now most of the softwares are actually doing it automatically, so you don't have to know the definition. Or Fibonacci line, especially the confluence of Fibonacci. So when I'll take a webinar on Fibonacci, then probably you'll understand how to draw Fibonacci and how to take advantage of the confluence. And major turning points, and probably it is extremely important to understand the turning concept of turning point in the market. Now the effects of supply demand in trading, the ones which I told you, it can be graphically represented as this. This is the pivot, PIB monthly, and this is resistance 1 monthly, resistance 2 monthly on top of pivot, and resistance 3 monthly. Below we have the support 1, support 2, support 3. And it is also possible to actually overlap of weekly pivot, as this one PIBW, weekly pivot on top of a monthly pivot, and see what happens to the price when the weekly pivot is appearing at the below the monthly pivot. This pivot line, once it is coming on the first day of the month, will stay for 30 days or 31 days or 20 days for the February. This weekly pivot, once it is coming on the completion of the first bar on a weekly Monday morning, it will stay there till Friday close. That's why they are leading indicators. The effects of supply demand in trading. So let's see, this is a pivot and price actually crossed the pivot and got bounced on the resistance 1 on the weekly. It came back and got a support at the pivot and again went close above the resistance 1 and continued, because the highs are taken out consistently till the resistance 2, and from there it came down straight to support 1. In between it got stuck in resistance 1 and resistance 2, pivot. So it is extremely important to understand the price action around these supply demand points so that you can book profit, enter and put stop loss and so on and so forth. If you are drawing a Fibonacci, for example, if you have no one knows the right hand side, but if price is getting stuck at this point, it is a good question to ask is where to draw the Fibonacci. So Fibonacci should be drawn from the previous swing low to the swing high to know the retracement, and we got a 78.6 support, not only once with a hammer, second time with a doji, third time with an outside bar which is an engulfing, I told you. So price got support 3 times at this Fibonacci level. So that can be an extremely important hidden support and resistance line, because if you have not drawn it, they are hidden from your charting software. Now the hidden support and resistance, for example this can be a monthly low. So when this is appearing on January, for consider this is January, this is February, when this is appearing on the February, month of February, what we need to do is we need to draw a low, draw a straight line, and this is the trough support because this is drawn at a swing low, and this low when it is coming here is getting tested again and again, and price formed a new swing low, and I call this phenomenon as crack and snap back, and it cracked through the previous support line, formed a new support line and reversed back. So these are the resistances and supports which are actually known as supply and demand, and it can be drawn in higher time frames like a monthly or weekly, so that you can take advantage in future. Now identification of hidden support and resistance, the confirmed lines, this one here, red one, is the yearly, this is actually the quarterly lines, and these are monthly lines. So see how price is actually getting support and resistance on your price supply and demand, or the hidden support and resistances. Unless and until you have drawn it, you don't know what price is doing, and it will behave like a random action. Another example here, my mouse is very sensitive. So on the support and resistance, when the price got stuck on the yearly and quarterly line, and then it clears this, retested many times, and then it straight came down. So this is a free fall because there is no support and resistance here, also free fall, and so on and so forth. The wave structure of price. The price can also be represented as 1-2-3 wave, and actually always price never moves in a straight line. Price always moves in a wave structure. If it is going up, it will go up and then retrace back to a Fibonacci level and then again go up. So it is important to know this wave structure, because first if it is forming a base, and after this base formation it is going up and then it is coming down a little bit, this is a retracement. This is not the start of a new trend, and a retracement. The new trend will start when it is broken one support and it has broken the second one as well. So you can also use a zigzag line. Most of the softwares are also giving these zigzag lines here. So you can have a big zigzag line on the front term of blue, maybe 3%, and the green and pink maybe 1%. So you'll understand within the 3% which you have defined which is the impulsive move and the corrective. Impulsive, corrective, so on and so forth. And when this blue line turns into red and this matches pink line with the red, then we have our impulsive down, and the green here are corrective uptrend, are not trend actually, corrective price movements. All put together, I told you human emotions plots the price action. As human emotion is constant, so is the market behavior. Trending market moves in waves, making higher high, higher low, or lower high, lower low. As I told you, to identify the up bar and the down bar and the combination of peaks and troughs. When price is in a range or consolidation, then it stays sideways, and there are many ways to know the price is in a sideways. The Bollinger band will be flat, and so on and so forth. Market structure and dynamics can be understood by applying the principles of different market concepts as discussed before. Now let me tell you the special offers only to the Go Market clients. We have come out with very special offers only for Go Market clients. You will get a humongous privilege discounts when you enroll to any or a combination of our services. To know more about how to cross the threshold and get started and understand the dynamics and structure and underlying mechanics of the market like a professional does, you need to click on the, first you have to go to www.npfinancials.com.au and then go to the Client Arena tab. To take advantage of professional knowledge required to understand and trade, you have to click on the npfinancials.com first.au and then the services tab. To join our forex trading open discussion and hear me out, open up my trading knowledge as you saw in last 39 minutes, please click on the contact us and give your details so that we can get in touch with you. To take advantage of our mentoring sessions, please contact us at info@npfinancials.com.au. As you can see, we have starting from the basics of trading. We have one-on-one coaching, so this can be done through Skype or Google Hangouts or one-on-one in our office at Wheelersill to Brandon Park Drive, Melbourne, or wherever you are, because I have students across Australia, across the globe. We also run the Trader Foundation course, which is a 3 month course, and that is a guarantee that after doing this 3 month course, you don't have to go anywhere to know anything regarding the structure and dynamics and mechanics of the market. Then we have a 6 month mentorship program, in which I will talk about how to take advantage of our daily strategy, where to buy, where to put the stop loss, and where to book the profit. Then we will progress to the advanced trading progression, which is the next trading strategy based on the proprietary 12 hourly trading, and the professional trader development is the 12 month, which will consist of the daily strategy, the 12 hourly strategy, and a 4 hourly intra week strategy. If you are custom coding already but you need help, you can get in touch with us. We'll help you here in your custom coding. If you want to scan, especially for the share market, now also forex, because there are 200 or more countries and there are can be 1,000 combinations of instruments in forex, if you want to scan the market so that you are getting results within 1 minute, we can help you on your market scanning system. And if you are really interested to develop your trading system as such, maybe it is any kind of trading system, we'll definitely help you on that. And special offer only to the Go Market clients. Again, this is a very special offer only to the Go Market clients. You will get a actual discount when you enroll to any of the combination of our services, which you'll find in our trading tab in npfinancials.com.au. Market dynamics and mechanics. You can join us in our monthly trader sessions, which we take through all our trading and we discuss all the setups. You can take advantage of our proprietary mapping the market and bar by bar trading or demand and supply trading and the market structure, which you saw a glimpse of it in last 42 minutes. Okay, interesting. This is trader competition. Please provide your understanding and interpretation of how you can start your trading through our market structure and dynamics approach in details in writing. The winner will get a 30 minutes mentoring session with me, which is generally valued at $225 for our paid client. Please submit your entry at support@gomarkets.com.au. Let's stay connected. As I told you, my name is Partha Banerjee. Our company is npfinancials.com.au. You can contact me at 0395667275 or partha@npfinancials.com.au. Sorry, there is no dot after Partha. I don't know why there is a dot. That's a typo. And you can develop yourself as a professional trader if you go to npfinancials.com.au and take advantage of our tailor-made professional services at npfinancials.com.au/services. A very big thank you for your time and patience, and happy trading the market structure and dynamics. Bye for now.